With Hell's Kitchen attacked from all sides and very few willing to defend it, will Matt Murdock be ready to make the ultimate choice? Well, let's find out together, shall we, as we hop into the pages of Daredevil issue number 19. So, picking up from where the last issue left off, the wealthy and super corrupt Stormwind twins, feeling their stranglehold on Hell's Kitchen was loosening, opted to instead drop a bunch of money on hiring a supervillain army, made up of such Daredevil favorites as Bullseye, Bullet, Crossbones, the Rhino, and an even newer version of Stiltman to just level the whole place to protect their investment. Now, Matt Murdock and Detective North are still stuck outside the city limits at the moment. The dirty cops are stopping anyone from going in or out at the moment, but in our hero's absence, something rather interesting begins to happen. You remember all throughout this run, we've seen all these would-be vigilantes, people dressing up in homemade Daredevil costumes to try and keep the peace in their streets when the police wouldn't do it. Well, we get reacquainted with quite a few of them here in this issue. If the real Daredevil is missing and if the cops aren't going to help them, then these people are going to take up arms themselves and fight back to save their homes and their community, and it's all pretty damn amazing. Bullseye is none too impressed. At first, he's actually excited at the prospect of killing Daredevil, but once he realizes that these are all a bunch of fakes, he actually gets quite mad, even shooting at an unarmed mother and her child who were trying to flee. The Owl, on the other hand, is only happy with this turn of events. After all, Hell's Kitchen has proved to be quite difficult for him to conquer. This way, his enemies, the Libras family, will be crushed, and all of her black market customers will be forced to go elsewhere to do their business, meaning the Owl cleans up twice. Things are getting so dire, even the Kingpin and Wesley try to get involved and lend a hand to the Hell's Kitchen community. They want to get the media involved, but it seems that the Stormwinds have paid them off too. Perhaps one of the most interesting revelations, though, to take place during this siege of Hell's Kitchen actually takes place at the church that we've seen Matt frequent all throughout the series. The Rhino is ready to bulldoze it, but the church and the people inside end up finding an unlikely hero in the form of Sister Elizabeth. That's that nun that Matt has been spilling his guts to all series long. Turns out Elizabeth is not her real name, it's Mary, as in Typhoid Mary. The superpowered, split personality having on-again, off-again love interest to Matt Murdock himself, but is she here to help or hurt, though? We can't be certain. Now, by the time Matt and Cole do finally manage to make their way into the kitchen, everything's already going to hell in a handbasket. A bunch of the actual good cops who were here doing their job trying to arrest the Owl are dead, and so is that poor main vigilante stabbed in the stomach, much like the same way Elektra was by Bullseye back in the day. This does manage to give Matt something of an epiphany. He had shamed the Daredevil mantle by getting all messed up on pills and taking a life. Even if it was by accident, he knew he could never wear the suit again. And yet, right here, right now, Hell's Kitchen has come together around Daredevil as their symbol of justice. They redeemed the identity in Matt's eye, and now they need Daredevil more than ever. Matt takes up the mask of the fallen man and challenges Bullseye to a showdown. For tonight in Hell's Kitchen, as it was in the past, as it will always be, the devil is born again. And so that was Daredevil 19, everybody, and if you couldn't tell, it was exemplary, it was stupendous, it was honestly, I'm sure, something that Zdarsky had been planning for a long time. It's truly amazing to see all these little pieces start paying off and getting to that next level of Matt Murdock's own personal journey of self-discovery. I like that Hell's Kitchen and the people who live there are just as much characters in this story as anything else. I like that Wilson Fisk the Kingpin once again shows himself to be a layered, morally complex character who also doesn't want to stand by and see Hell's Kitchen destroyed by the Stormwinds. I like that Typhoid Mary has literally been under our nose this whole time. It makes me want to go back and reread a bunch of the scenes with her and Matt to see if there were any hints being dropped. I like the fact that this feels like a big, exciting exclamation point, yet there's clearly so much story left to go and that Zdarsky is only getting started with Daredevil. I would give this issue a 10 out of 10. In a series and a character that has so many high points, I feel we're going to be talking about the moments here in this one for a long time to come.
Hey there, everyone. It's your old pal Cave Joel again. Just wanted to take a moment to thank you so much for watching to the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, and if you're in the market for comic books right now, and I mean really, who isn't, you might want to check out my book depository link down in the description. It's no joke my favorite place to buy comic book trades. You get a great price, and if you use my link, not only will you be getting yourself something nice, but you'll be helping out the channel a little bit while you do so. So you win, I win, everybody wins, right? And until next time, everyone, this has been Cave Joel. Bye-bye.